In today's FX markets, let's take a look at the euro today as the euro is reversing a couple days of selling pressure today. We're seeing the euro higher on the session, currently right around the 1.179 level. And as I mentioned, we did see a couple of days of lower closes. Today we actually saw again the euro reestablishing this uptrend. And with that, we're also seeing the euro reversing out of initial selling pressure earlier this morning. So we did see the euro actually lower at one point during the session, but then regaining some traction here in the afternoon and maintaining, again, the higher end of the range for today's price action. If we look at some of the driving factors today, I think you got to point at a couple of things here. Number one, the stalemate that appears to be taking place in Congress about the U.S. stimulus package, I think, is having a negative impact on the U.S. dollar, and therefore, I think, helping to benefit some of the majors today. We are seeing most of the majors higher, although the British pound is slightly lower today, but most of the other major currencies are gaining strength versus the dollar today. And the other thing I want to point out, I think, that's pretty interesting is the fact that we continue to see interest rates here in the United States pushing lower, and could again be a reaction to the fact that we are seeing the stimulus package stalling out. But nonetheless, we're looking at the 10-year pushing down to basically the lowest levels since that March shakeup. And with that, I think that's, a headwind for the U.S. dollar and therefore benefiting some of these other currencies. So I think that's another factor here today. And also, again, the COVID-19 storyline is also playing into, I think, some of the price action between various regions within the globe, and certainly, I think, having an impact on how some of these currencies are reacting on a day-to-day basis as well. Looking at some of the trends in place, it is interesting as we are seeing the euro now coming off basically two-year highs, that it doesn't surprise, I think, a lot of traders, at least to this point, because when you look at the RSI relative strength index, it's in very overbought. Basically, it's been overbought for some time. I think market participants were kind of looking for this pullback, but at the same time, I still think that just being overbought in and of itself doesn't necessarily mean that we're going to see further downside for the euro. I think it's going to possibly take some other shifting dynamics. But when you look at the euro versus the British pound today, we are seeing, again, at least a reversal of that pattern. We have seen in the last couple of weeks the British pound gaining a little strength relative to the euro. But today we're seeing the euro reversing that short-term downtrend and pushing back up above the spot 90 level when you look at the euro versus the British pound.